Students, so we'll go to the next topic, that is writing to a file. So we have used the fopen function and we have opened a file. Now we want to write into that file. So then we can use a function called as fwrite function, which is going to write the data into the file. Whichever that is, either you can specify the length. So until it reaches that, until it finishes that length, it is going to write the data, or until it reaches the end of the file. Okay, it is going to write the data into the file which you have opened. Okay, so again it takes two parameters. So first one is a file variable of the file which you have opened, and the string to be written to the file. Okay, so these are the two parameters what it is taking, and it returns the number of bytes written. How many number of bytes is written into the open file is going to return that value. So you can see here fwrite. So file variable. So file variable is nothing but which file you have opened. So pointer to that, that is your file variable, followed by out.data. So out.data, in this case it is a variable in which some string data is there, or you can directly pass some string also. Okay, so in that case all those data will be written into the file pointed to by this file variable. Okay, and this byte written is nothing but how many number of bytes that is written, that will be stored here. Okay, next one you have is file put contents. So this file put contents is just opposite of file get contents. In previous video you had seen that, in which case it is going to read the contents of the file, that is file get content, whereas in this case it is put content. So this function writes the value of the second parameter, that is a string, to the file specified in the first parameter. So whatever is present in the second parameter, that is in this particular variable whose name is str, those contents are written into the file named savedata.dat. Okay, so this is your file put content, which is just the opposite of file get content. Okay, so we'll just see one example here. So we have a example program here. So you can see here. So first we have used fopen. So fopen, which is used to open a file in which the parameters are the name of the file followed by the indicator, or you can also call it as a mode. Okay, so what does this read do? R do, R is nothing but you have to open a file in the read mode. Okay, if the file is not present, it is going to give you an error message. But if you are given as write, in case a file is not present, it is going to create the file. So we'll just see with this first. So we have given as read mode, we'll just execute this and see what we are going to get. So read mode, so here you can see here a warning message saying that no such files or directory, and you can see an error cannot open. So this is nothing but this is the thing what you have written in or die. So what did we say for or die? That is your die function. So what is the meaning of die function? So in this case the file hi.txt is not present, so it is not possible to open the file hi.txt in the read mode. So in that case fopen is going to return you a false value. Okay, so that is handled by this die function. So it is going to display this error message. Now the same thing, we'll just modify it, we'll change it to write. Okay, and we'll see what will happen now. So you can see here the same file. Now you can see message is displayed saying that data is written successfully. What is this message? We'll see now. So what happened now? We are trying to open the file hi.txt in write mode. Okay, so in the write mode, in case the file is not present, it is going to create the file. Okay, and after that we are using fwrite function. So what is this fwrite function? It is going to write the string, whatever you have given here, it is going to write into the file pointed to by this file variable. So this file variable fp is pointing to which file? Hi.txt. So you can just open that hi.txt and see. Okay, you can open hi.txt and see what is there in that. So you just see in hi.txt you have welcome to file handling. That is the same message what you have written here. That is your fwrite function. Okay, then that is just a read mode. Next, what is this data return successful? This is just a print statement what I've given. So this data return successful is nothing but what you're seeing in your browser. So this is just an example program. Okay, so I hope you have understood this write to a file. So in write to a file you have fwrite. What does fwrite do is whatever you have written as a second parameter, that data will be written to the file pointed to by your file variable. Okay, so it might it will write until it reaches the end of the file, or until what is the length you have given, until that is done it will write. Okay, so in this case what is the data I have given? I have given welcome to file handling. Until this entire thing is done it will be writing. Okay, then in fput test what happened? That is just the opposite of fget test. So what did we say in fget test? It is going to read the entire contents of file, fget test. Whereas in this case it is going to write. So what is happening here in str, whatever you have, that data is written to the file called as savedata.dat. Okay, so this is about your writing to a file. Hope you have understood this. Thank you.